Hey, what's up, guys? So up next, we're gonna do Weird Al, stop forwarding that crap to me. Now look, I stand behind this song 100%. If you are the type of person that likes to send any type of junk, this is my message to you. Please stop forwarding that crap to me. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, the sand keeps falling through the hourglass, and there's no way you're gonna slow it down. You say we gotta treasure each moment. Who knows how long we're gonna be around?
Now look, some of y'all might not realize this. Weird Al can sing his ass off. He can sing any genre of music he wants. For any type of artist or anybody else who doesn't take Weird Al seriously because he does parodies, they're totally mistaken. Do not underestimate this man.
Yeah, you keep on telling me life is short, and it's hard to disagree with what you say. But if time is so precious, why you wasting mine? 'Cause I'm always reading, always deleting every useless piece of garbage that you send my way. Every stupid hoax, all those corny jokes, stop forwarding that crap to me.
Let's go, Weird Al.
Well, I don't need tons of cringe-inducing puns. Stop forwarding that crap to me.
I'm right there with you on that, Weird Al. He says, no more corny jokes. Just stop it. You know what I'm saying?
No, it isn't okay if you brighten my day with some cut and paste and hackneyed Hallmark poetry. And I didn't request a personality test. Stop forwarding that crap to me. You're sending virus-laden man with attachments to every single person you know. You pass around a link to some dumb thing on YouTube that everybody else already saw 3 years ago. And why keep badly?
He said everybody already saw it 3 freaking years ago. Hey, Weird Al is a trip, y'all.
Photoshop.
I'm going to have to look into that. You know, I've seen this video a long time ago, right? So I didn't really remember anything that was in it. But yeah, I'm kind of glad that we did come here, because this Snopes thing, is that a real thing? If it is, we might have to be all over that. You know what I'm saying? Because busting urban legends and myths and that's what I'm all about, y'all.
I don't want a bowl of chicken soup for the soul. Stop forwarding that crap
okay.
to me. Send more top 10 lists and I'll slash my wrist. Please
oh,
stop
no.
forwarding that crap to me.
Now look, I gotta be honest with y'all. That type of sentiment right there, I just hate it. I hate it so much for that to be in any type of media. You know, that is such a serious topic. And so many people just, you know, I just wish the times would change and we would stop making light of it. You know? That's just how I view it, y'all.
That crap to me, like glittery hearts and unicorns and pictures of somebody's cat. Now tell me, in what alternate reality would I care about something like that? And by the way, your quotes from George Carlin aren't really George Carlin. Mr. Rogers never fought the Viet Cong. And Bill Gates is never gonna give me something for nothing. And I highly doubt some dead girl's gonna kill me if I don't.
Hey, those are the worst. I know some of you guys are just so hung up on those chain letters, right? If you don't send this to everybody you care, I'm not even going to read it. Look, this, whoever decided that would be a good idea, I don't understand it. Like, I have better things to do with my time. You know what I'm saying? Like, having conversations. You know, having real conversations about stuff that actually matters. passing a letter along so that someone's spirit doesn't come back and haunt you, okay, is just absurd. I have to do this or they're gonna send this thing after me. Get real. You know, there's a good way to prove that's not real. Don't apply to it. Just say, okay, that's fine. Send your ghost after me. Wait a year. Wait 2 years. Wait 3 years. No ghost? Okay. You know why? Because it's not real. That stuff doesn't exist, y'all. Like, I'm just being honest with y'all. That's how I feel about it. I believe in a lot of stuff, but, I believe in spirits, okay, but this whole thing of, when we die, sometimes we have unfinished business, and then we can go and haunt people and do all this other stuff. No, come on. When we die, our business is finished right then and there. We have no more business on earth at all. You know what I'm saying? It's done. Whatever business you had, no matter how important it was, you know, trying to solve a crime, trying to do this, trying to do that, when you're gone, you're gone. There is no more, you know, of anything on earth. That's just how it is, y'all.
I'll sign your petition, but stop forwarding that crap to me. And I don't want to...
Oh, now look, so I know a lot of you guys are going to hear that and you're going to say, well, that's just wrong, right? It's not wrong. Trust me on this because I'm getting ready to prove it to you. Okay? So, if you... I believe the Bible. I take it at its word, okay? Now, the Bible says in heaven, there is no sadness. There is no sickness. There's no, everything is good, okay? If you were to have unfinished business on earth, you would be in heaven, right? And you would be, you know, missing your kids and missing your family and... you know, wishing you could still be experiencing life with them, right? That would be sadness in heaven. Sadness, there is no sadness in heaven. You see what I'm saying now? So you can't say, there's no sadness in heaven, but you believe spirits can come back and haunt people, right? You can't, it doesn't work that way. You know, when we leave this earth, our time on earth is done. We're going one place or the other. There's no in between. There's no, none of that stuff. Y'all. Now look, I know some of you guys are going to be disappointed, because I've just explained that to you. All right. That's the truth. You know, I'm going to quote Tom McDonald right now. Facts don't care about feelings. You know what I'm saying? They just don't. You know, I hope some of you guys, at least, are watching me for my opinions. And you want to see how I do analysis on things. That's how I do it. You know, I think about it in a realistic and a logical manner. That's it. Just some common sense. You know?
Read your series of conspiracy theories. Just stop forwarding that crap. Hey.
Most of the conspiracy theories, I won't even pay attention to them. Unless there is at least some credibility to it. It has to be at least feasible. If it's not even feasible, and there's no evidence whatsoever to corroborate it, then guess what? You've got a conspiracy theory. It's a theory. It's, you know, if you believe it, then set out to prove it. You know, you believe in aliens, that's fine. Go out and show me some. I'm waiting. You know, and not no CG mess, none of that. You know, come on now. I mean, really, you guys, like, just think about it. If aliens were real, wouldn't we walk outside and see UFOs all the time? Like, they're only gonna show up in, what's that fort? I don't remember what it was called, but y'all know what I'm talking about. That military base, that supposedly that's where they keep all the aliens and stuff. Come on. Like, get real. You know what I'm saying?
And your 2 million loser friends all have my address now, cause you never figured out the way to be CC. Now I got,
I don't know what that
insist.
Is either.
Take me off of your list. Stop forwarding.
Just send me a message and say, hey, how you doing? That's it. That's all you got to do. Don't send me spam. Right?
That crap to me.
Stop forwarding that crap to me. Stop forwarding that crap to me.
I know someone I'm going to forward this to. He definitely needs to do it. You know? Mr. Void. All right, you got to do this one, because I know he's going to love this one.
Stop forwarding the crap to me. Stop forwarding the crap to me.
Just stop it now.
Stop forwarding the crap.
Since I mentioned him, I'll put a link to his channel in the description. All right, as of right now, he is literally one of my favorite reactors to watch. Every single night, you know, I know usually late at night, somewhere around usually between 12 and maybe 2 a.m., he's going to drop some stuff, usually, okay? And I just look forward to that all the time. You know, has Mr. Boyd dropped any videos yet? No, not yet. And then as soon as I see the first one that I like, I gotta see what all he's dropped. you know, cause I sent him some requests. He's not got to them yet. But y'all, it's going to be a blast once he does. Hey, look at him trying to click the X button. Man, all the freaking time I'm doing that. You know, when I'm browsing the web or whatever. It gets me so freaking mad. Because I'm trying to read a web page, right? And then just constantly get all these boxes coming up, right? You want to go to Reddit to read this. Oh, I'm already on a web page. Let me go to the web page. Continue with Google or whatever, right? Then you're trying to read something else. Then there's ads popping up covering the whole screen. You can't find the X button sometimes. It's a mess. And it's like, what are y'all doing? You know, like, if y'all are getting money by putting ads on the screen, then why don't you make those ads not intrusive, right? So then they'll stay on the screen longer. So you'd make more money, wouldn't you? But no, I don't think they do it for money. I think they do it just to piss us off. That's what they're doing it for. Let's see. He's not even, he's going to try to click the X button again. Yep. What? He's going to click it again now. I love that, y'all. He said, at the risk of sounding slightly repetitious or something like that. That is hilarious. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I love Weird Al, y'all. What a terrific artist he is. I don't want it. Don't send it to me. Don't send it to me. Stop forwarding the crap to me. Just stop. Stop forwarding the crap to me. Oh, stop forwarding that crap to me. To me. That was a great song, Weird Al. All right, I will see y'all in the next video. Until then, I'm out.